full motion 787 simulator.
Takeoff, we will get engine 5.
So there was a one engine out on takeoff. You always prepare for the worst scenario.
Engine failed.
So we start with engine fire, now
it's
engine failure.
Fire plane self-dual autoland with one engine up.
I would suggest to fuel Jettison to lower to the max landing weight.
And we're gonna fly the Dreamliner on the flight simulator, right?
Yeah.
Wow, I have never flown a Dreamliner simulator.
Really?
It must be very new to Turkish Airlines, right?
Yeah,
it's just new.
Wow, looking forward to
it. Great.
Full motion 787 simulator. In here, they have to have a 21 degree room temperature to keep the simulator, the condition. We're just waiting. The captain allow us to go inside to take a look.
Welcome to our training facility. This is Dreamliner simulator. There is no difference between real airplane and simulator device. That's why we call this simulator as a level D approved with zero flight time training. So that means when you get training here, you can fly real airplane as a co-pilot.
Hello, my name is Roland Oberhauser. I'm from Austria actually. On that flight, I'm the commander. And this is my friend, hi, going with me today.
Hello, my name is Ulaşberk Bayramoğlu and I'm from Turkey. With this flight, I'm with my commander and my stretches as a first officer in this flight.
Today's sim section will cover hot takeoff. That means he will use a hot display during takeoff. But during takeoff, he will get engine fire. So that means he will shut down one of the engine. He will extinguish the fire. And we will take off with the maximum takeoff weight. That means he will need fuel dump before landing.
Coming in. Oh, this is very cool. This is.
Turkish
550
170
degrees, 5 knots,
takeoff runway
20 center. Runway 20 center, clear for takeoff, Turkish
550.
Yes, sir.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
You have control.
I have controls. We have communication.
Takeoff.
Left non-normal checklist. Track, cell.
Track,
cell, checked. Auto turtle arm switch left. Confirm.
Off. Confirm.
Thrust levers left. Confirm.
Confirm.
Idle.
I continue.
You continue.
Cruise control switch left. Cut off. Confirm.
FM. Right thrust left.
Check. Left engine fire switch. Confirm.
On. Confirm.
If fire engine message stays shown, it stays shown. Rotate and hold for 1 second.
Check.
One time. I open the checklist.
Yes, sir. Declare emergency.
Mayday, mayday, mayday. Turkish 5-5 heavy. Engine fire. Proceeding straight ahead. Enter the holding.
So there was a one engine out on takeoff after V1. But it was still flying very smoothly. So what we're doing is now, given ATC given us 3,500 feet maintaining this level. So we will dump some fuel. As we had a maximum takeoff weight out of Singapore, so now we're dumping fuel and then circling and then later return back to land.
We lose the one of the engine and the right engine. Right engine is running right now, left engine is the gun. So we start with engine fire, now it's engine failure. Options, we are holding over Singapore. So the best things also to turning back to Singapore, or we can discuss. And risks, we can lose the other engines, by the way. So according to this information, my decision with evaluating all the things also, my decision to turn back to Singapore. What would you think?
Yes, I agree to that. I would suggest we do fuel jettison to lower to the max landing weight.
Yes, sir.
And then make a landing. Weather is fine. I would just ask for the runway used, and we can prepare for that.
Check.
And also, I would ask for the fuel jettison.
Fuel jettison, yes.
Singapore Turkish 55.
Turkish 55 now landing in US will be runway 02 left, ILS approach.
We can see now that the fuel is running here out of the aircraft. These are the nozzles on the right wing, on the left wing, where the fuel is pumped out of the aircraft. And we see the fuel to remain in magenta. That means we will have 27.8 tons of fuel, which gives us the maximum landing weight. And the jettison time from now will be 27 minutes. That's the time it takes until the fuel is out.
In simulation, you always practice for the worst scenario.
Yeah,
because in real scenario, we probably never seen on takeoff, you have one engine flame out, then you dump fuel, then you come back to land.
You should fly at least 30 years to get the one engine failure. So that means it is rare.
Very rare.
Yeah, but in this one, so that means I should create a scenario in the worst scenario. Let's say you assume that we lost the engine, you will do landing. But think that the worst scenario. So that the worst scenario, you assume you will do land, but you will do go around. Okay? Always action is changing.
110.
You have to make a decision. The decision is, as it says in the checklist, you have to consider fuel jettison or you have to make an overweight landing. So if time permits and it's not actually very critical, it's better to reduce the max landing weight. That's what we did. We did the fuel jettison checklist, and the computer calculates how much fuel we have to jettison to get down to a maximum landing weight. It also tells us how long the fuel jettison will need. So we are aware of the situation, how long it takes, and how much fuel we have to chat with.
This time, captain will fly, but just he will monitor the situation. Co-pilot do pilot monitoring duty. So airplane itself do auto-land with one engine up in the with 25 crosswind. So I just 25 crosswind here.
Singapore Turkish 5 miles.
Runway 02 left, clear to land, Turkish 5-5-7.
Roll out, we are on plane 3.
Alert,
check.
Minimums.
Continue, check.
50. 40, 30, 20, 10.
Speed brakes up. No reversers, left engine.
Autopilot is
good. Check.
And earthquake.
Check. Last question. 60 knots.
Check.
Position Turkish 5-5.
Okay, I have control.
You have control.
what scenario this will be low visibility takeoff, so they will depart with the visibility 150 meters. This is the critical visibility, so they will use the HUD display. So in case of worst scenario, let's say today they will have the rejected takeoff, so at critical stage, at critical speed, they will reject takeoff. So that means the aim of the captain to keep airplane on the center line. So you will see the actions. So now I will move from Singapore to New Istanbul Airport.
Stabilized.
Trust you.
Takeoff thrust set.
Check.
Check.
Hold.
Engine check.
Fail.
Engine failed. Speed breaks up. Reverse is normal. Istanbul Turkish 55. Stopping on runway 35 right.
Check. Yes, engine. Five.
Engine failed right.
Check.
Turkish turbulent. What happened? During takeoff, at critical stage, engine failed. So captain should do reject before critical speed. So we call this speed is V1. That means decision speed. So he got the decision. He rejected takeoff. So what action he did? So immediately thrust lever idle. Same time he disengage auto thrust. He will use the full reverse thrust. Same time he will keep a plane on the center line while using head-up display. Then he will check the speed, then he inform the speed below minimum speed, we call it around the 60 knots, inform that we are doing rejected takeoff to ATC because there are other airplane approaching the runway. So that means it is critical to communicate them the tower. So you know the tower did go around the approaching airplane because we assume that this will depart, but normal airplane couldn't depart due to engine failure. So this was properly done, well done. So your next order will be low visibility approach with 75 meters RVR.
Flight and flight stop.
Check.
Rollout flare up, main 3.
Check.
In this scenario, we have low visibility operation in Istanbul. So this airplane can do auto land with K3B condition.
50, 40, 30, 20, 10.
Speed breaks up. Reverses, no reverses right engine. Reverses normal caps.
So in this case, with 75 meters, we land to Istanbul near airport. So you see that airplane did itself. So at lower speed, captain disengage autopilot, he got to control.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome, captain.
Was
thank
great,
you.
Great, great landing, really.
Thank
great.
You so much.
Ever seen, never seen before.
Thank you. It was my pleasure to fly with you. Thank you.
Well, Captain Roland and First Officer, I also want to thank you very much and our instructor here giving me this special experience to see a lot of scenarios that rarely happens, but as a pilot, you always prepare for the worst scenario and you always keep a cool head knowing what to do during a situation like this. So thank you very much for this experience. Thank you.
Oh my gosh. Another certificate here. Observation flight certificate. This is amazing.